today because we believe in freedom and we stand in solidarity with the people of Iran. We stand against the mullahs who have caused untold terror in your beloved country. With your repression, with their repression and reign of terror, the mullahs deny the people of Iran the pride of their extraordinary heritage, a heritage admired across the globe. Iran, a country which gave us the first human civilization, ahead of Egypt by 500 years, must be free. Iran, which created the first accounting tools, King Darius of Persia wrote the first human rights charter some 2,500 years ago. It is still engraved in the Alvand Mountain near the ancient Persian capital of Hagmatana. It was this concept of human rights, freedom of religion, and the equality of all races that led to the freedom of the Jews from the captivity of Babylon by Cyrus the Great of Persia. So today, in recognition of the great gifts of the great land of Iran, it is time for the mullahs to live up to the legacy of respect for freedom and human rights, which are the legacy and the proper inheritance of the Iranian people. The mullahs, Iran targets dissidents, journalists, protesters, ethnic and religious minorities, and human rights defenders. The mullahs imprison, torture, and sentence to death those who dare speak truth to power. Executions in Iran surged last year, 469 people as of December 15, 2016. More people are executed in Iran than any other country in the world save China. The largest group the mullahs target makes up fully half the population of Iran, and that is women. Women in Iran comprise half the students in higher education, yet make up only 16% of the workforce. It is time to free the women of Iran. We cannot say we do not know. The time has long passed for Iran to end these widespread abuses. They are wrong, and they are violations of international law. It is time to free Iran. One thing that holds us all in common are two experiences. And that first experience is suffering, but the other experience every human being also has is the experience of love. And that is what you are trying to bring to Iran. You're trying to bring back to that country a government that's based on humanity, not on suffering, not on oppression, but on compassion and love for one another. And in that, all the world is with you. And I am proud to stand with you today.